Hello, I'm Patricia McNeely. I'm in a Blumend Blu-ray Twin Flame from Chicago, Illinois. I am also of the Golden Ray of the Golden Sun, which means I have been to and touched down on the New Earth. And actually Rainbow Ray, and we're encompassing all this stuff here. So I have a question for you. Are you done with the drama? Are you done looking at your twin and seeing just the negatives? Are you done confusing passion for drama? Are you ready to really put the passion back into your union? The passion into where it belongs and where it's appropriate? In your bedroom, not out for public display, not for embarrassing you. So today is Tuesday, November 25th. In 2 days here in the United States, it is our Thanksgiving holiday. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about backstory, as well as bringing it to the now in giving thanks. Now, the very first thing I really want to talk to you about is some of the reasons or the root cause for why your twin flame seems blasé or seems to be able to go on with a mundane life when you know darn well you are here for one thing only. You're here to be with that person. You're here to be with the love. And there's some reasons for that. And we're going to start by saying that as of the end of October, and particularly from November 1st, but right around 11-11, the 11th was the Lover's Gate. So I hope a lot of you made it through the Lover's Gate, because there was a lot of mental confusion in the air. There were a lot of things that made it look like it was going backwards. There were a lot of you that needed to put some things on hold. And I myself, I had some computer problems. I got backed up on stuff. I had I had things freeze up to where the only thing I could do was focus on me. And I did it. But it kind of put me behind the eight ball in certain ways. And, you know, that's what happens because your union is the priority. Putting people's souls back together as one is the priority of the entire universe. And there's reasons for it. It's because it's new. It's also because twin flames, the love of twin flames is source love. And that love creates new. Whether it's inspirations, creations, whether it's taking down old stuff, whether it is repairing and restoring parts of DNA, whether it's healing, whether it's just fresh inspiration. So, what are we going to talk about today? Well, sorry, but the gloves are going to be off. There's no way to sugarcoat some of this stuff about our backstories. And the first thing I'm going to talk to you about is there are several million people on the verge of really waking up, and their awakenings won't really be perceived as awakenings. They may really be perceived as spiritual emergencies acting out, things breaking up, things just exploding out of control. And there's a reason, because this stuff is welling up from a deep place. It is every time you fill yourselves with light and love, there's stuff that comes out of your cells. And many of you have been detoxing. Many of you have been through several cycles of it. And for some of you, it's been really big cycles. Some of you started 20 years ago. Some of you knew that when you got to a certain point, you were really hoping to be done, only to find out, guess what, there's more. It's going to end, though, at a certain point. And this new beginning, this past Saturday, the new moon of November 22nd, this was the new beginning. And I hope a lot of you like stuck to what you know, because that's all it took. Sticking to what you know in order to drift and coast into this new energy. So some of you have to know when to put the accelerator and put the pedal to the metal, when to lift off. And some of you are getting good at that. Some of you are like, Patricia, I have no idea what's going on. Like, what just happened? You're going to find out. One of the things that I don't do, if you notice, is I don't cover old ground. I'm not still talking about, you know, the psychological reasons why this or this happened. We're about to repair a lot of this psyche damage. And so many Blu-ray twin flames are the big picture people. They're people with actual grid point unions. They're just not really here biding their time and doing certain things. And everyone's bringing something to the table. So if you don't know what that is for yourself or your union, you'll know very soon. Now, one of the things I want to talk to you about is where this damage occurred. It was from the implosion of Maya, which is a planet in the Palladian star system. Also Mars, right here in our own solar system. Maldek, also here in our solar system. Aldebaran, star system, several planets there. And I have personally re-experienced some of that. Sinara, and there's others. Those are actually the primary ones that a lot of people are initially going to be healing. In Maya, it was an invasion, and in Mars, it was endless warring. In Maldek, one of the ways that we formerly ascended was there was one twin flame couple that was the oversoul for a planetary ascension, and that was due to the personal separation of that one planetary oversoul, just one. And they separated, and the planet imploded, and those are the remnants of the asteroid belt. Aldebaran and Sinara, it was grave and deep damage to the sacred sexual. Now, what happened to twin flames after some of this, after some of these cataclysms? These events set in motion what could be called natural cataclysms, floods. Your planet is blown to bits. And that's an honest to God truth that has actually happened. If you don't think that things that happen at an atomic level affect your very God particle, you are sorely mistaken. You are not just a human being. And so those damages that have occurred have damaged the mental, emotional bodies, the psyche, and the ego mind. And you can't just explain it away or analyze it away. It needs deep healing. We're at that point now where the deep healings are going to start. And I know some of you really have been wondering and saying, you know, what's it going to take here? Yeah, it's taking a miracle. It is taking divine intervention. It is also taking the knowingness of what you know. And it is taking your participation. Yeah, you have to participate. Everyone here has some skin in the game. And yet it's not a game. This is serious because, as you can see, the choices that will be made that you're sometimes seeing with the true beloveds, you can say, you know, it's going to be death or some form of imprisonment or, you know, something else, you know, some kind of downturn in their health. And some of you can see the writing on the wall and you're saying, I don't know. But we are coming into the time where much of what's needed is moving into place. And my last video was about everything is moved into place. So hang on to what you believe, because all of your prayers, all of your intentions, those are going to start to be the wishes come true, and the small miracles and the big miracles. It's time for some of the big miracles. So what did people do when they had to survive? Like if they lost their twin, if they were separated, many people hooked up with really close soulmates, and because you got along so well, and maybe you're from the same soul group, and there's commonalities, there's also a lot of the mental alignments, things like, well, we get along with each other, we agree on things, we both take care of the kids the same way, you know. And yet many of the old 3D marriages are amounting to feeling like, if you're really lucky, it feels like your brother and a brother and a sister. If it's not feeling that way, it feels like glorified roommates where, well, that person has a really good heart, and yet what's going to happen? What's going to happen is that many times if you're awake and aware of who your twin is, and you're trying and struggling to hold an elevated state of your 5D union while your marriage is still there, your soul is not going to wrap itself around your marriage. You cannot glue it back together. You cannot get it better. You cannot even re-up at some point. It's done now. All of the comfort that we once found with each other, or the agreements to interact and play things out so that we did not incur further soul damage, it's done. It's done. Now, I understand that many people do have children. Those children came through the genetic lineage so that they could heal their genetic pain bodies, ethnic pain bodies, nationalities. Also, it's going to be time for the angelic parent, the counterpart, the divine counterpart, or the twin flame to show up and be a part of that child's life. And so finding the balance between your actual 4th dimensional, because many of you are in 4th dimension now. You're manifesting quicker, you've been healing from some things, you know more, your intuitions, you're like wired up, your bells and whistles are getting ready to go, and you just know stuff. And you've been dreaming it. This is taking on a momentum. Now, what winds up happening? Those old 3D marriages have connections in the mental and emotional bodies. Now, your mental emotional body, believe it or not, has been a part of what's inside you. So what's inside are several of your other bodies. And you know, you're out to here, you've got, you know, things that people call your aura and all kinds of stuff. But guess what? As you've cast yourself out all the way to the universe, and you've reconnected with source, you've made little, and if it's not you, if you're the partner who has been the one staying still, it's been your beloved. They have been making their reconnections, and Earth is one big healing center. At one point, I wanted to say, send more Palladians. What are we going to do? We need more healers. No, we don't. Everybody's here that needs to be here and get this ball rolling. You've actually been in place. Many of you have known. You've been waiting and saying, I've been waiting for 4 years for this. For some of you, it's 30 years. Some of you, it's 40 years, 20 years, 8 years, 7 years. You came here and you were born here just so you could put yourself together into oneness and be new. That's your mission. Now, you're putting yourself together in oneness in union with your beloved. Not, they are your partner. Everything else you're relating to, whether it's foods or situations or organizations or your family. So those internal parts of you are going to continue healing, and it's uncomfortable, and you're scraping yourself off. You're literally scraping this stuff off, clearing and cleaning your old connections. So the old connections of the 3D marriages, things like, well, we were married in a religious ceremony, and that religion made us make a vow that said, till death do you part. Red flag. Because that's going to be the very thing that is going to disturb your mental, emotional body, and your ego will kick in and say, how dare that person do that to you? Look at that. Oh, well, I know I should get a divorce, or you know what? They're really good at this or that, and they're so good looking. How could I give that up? And guess what? Your soul's going to take care of that, but it goes better, it goes smoother, it goes faster when you proactively create that. And that's been coming up a lot for people, and I very much applaud all of you who, from September to November, made a trip to where your twin flame is, cleaned out the house, and finished doing for them what they could not do for themselves, come back, and again, the mental confusion, like, what was that? I kept feeling I was going to meet them. You were cleaning and clearing your house. You were cleaning and clearing your grid or your emotional body, all of your universal connections that they've made, but maybe that they're stuck in it. And that's the part that is really going to take on here, because you've done the cleaning and clearing. Enough of you have done that cleaning and clearing, and yeah, some of you are really tired of empathically feeling everything. You're tired of transmuting stuff. You are not here to vacuum off other people. Catch yourself at these holidays coming up, because people around you will be going through some of their own awakening, and their stuff's going to pop out. It's already been happening. So what do you wind up with if you were stuck in a 3D marriage? If either you feel stuck or you are stuck, what do you wind up with? If you're staying in it, you wind up with what I call the reversal effect, where rather than, because you've already cleaned and cleared everything sufficiently from your union, but rather than doing it for your beloved, you start doing it for your spouse or your boyfriend or your girlfriend. And if you're living with that person, all the stuff that they're into, all of their old damage, all of the karma that they haven't concluded or that they keep staying on a track with, things like video games, war movies, watching the news, anything that triggers it up and keeps that repetitive pattern going. Or if you're in a business together and that business is, you know, you're like on a treadmill and it feels like it, you're on that gerbil wheel, you're going to wind up having their stuff doink over to you, and it's going to be their mental, emotional stuff, and it will give you uneasy nights. If you're sleeping right next to that person, I don't wish this upon anyone, but it will become very amplified and intense. And the intensity is that you're in the pressure cooker, and everything's kind of getting to the boiling point so that this stuff could evaporate. And you're not going to be in this forever. But it's up to you to continue moving yourself along through it. And this has been coming up in people's readings. I've been doing a lot of readings, as many as 6 a day, which is too much for me. And I've had to scale back because that's a lot of energetic work. But I have the ability to see people's unions multidimensionally, which means that I see behind the facade or the person that is the counterpart, and I see the damages, I see the core stuff, I see who the couple really is together, and furthermore, I feel it. I can feel the love of their union. I can also perceive when it is a false twin. And by the way, false twins, it's like we've pulled the plug on that dirty water. It's draining away. If you don't let go, you can't let it out. If you're hanging on to it, if you're re-engaging it in any way, shape, or form, it's going to continue. So let me move along here. The reason we're doing this is we are in the last part of the universal karma. And what is universal karma? It is the very first karma that we incurred with each other. And it was for our experiencing. It was to experience and to know certain things, certain levels of things, and this is in multiple dimensions, and sometimes in multiple environments. It could be a family environment and a work environment, and what you'll find as you move along here is that your own multidimensionality is actually here at play, and you're able to perceive it more, so you're not just able to say, well, I remember when that happened when I was a kid. You might get the amplified effect where you're like, it happened again when I was a kid, and then I just remembered on Mars or in Maya, and these people came, and then this guy came into my cubicle at work, and everything was just, I just felt so invaded. I felt like my space was invaded, and what do you know what you're having? You're having everything all come up at once, and it's anxiety, and it's like fight or flight, and your body, that is the part that you're struggling with. The human body is built for survival, so you will have fight or flight. You will have hormonal response systems. You'll have reactions. You'll have defense mechanisms. You'll have coping skills. None of that belongs in the new. So some people are very addicted to the chemicals that these bodies give off, the endorphins. They love the pain. They'll invite the pain. And they won't know how to get out of it. They can no longer recognize abusive situations. Why? Because a lot of them have gotten really good at coping with it. It could be an abusive boss. And instead of standing up to that person and saying, hey, listen, you can't talk that way to me. I had a boss like that. She had her whole family working there, and they had their whole, everything that happened at home in their childhood was in that office. And I knew it was now or never time, because this was one of the things I needed to get rid of for my union. And I said to my boss one day, I said, please don't speak to me that way. I will do anything you ask me to reasonably. But I said, I'm not a part of your family. This is strange to me. And she was sort of taken aback, but she actually knew what I was talking about. Now, never mind that I probably could have rolled with it, but I knew it was the time for me to stand up and say enough. And you know, your spirit is going to test you on when it's enough. What do you know that you know? Okay, we're going to move along here, because I have some more things to talk about now with this planetary damage. And yeah, this was big planetary damage. I mean, it's been depicted in Star Wars, and some people say, well, Patricia, that was Star Wars. That wasn't, you know, that's sci-fi. No, our truth is actually stranger than the fiction that's been created from it. So your universal karma, most of the themes of your universal karma are going to be comfort and health. This means the well-being of not only your physical vehicle that you may be in a third or fourth density level of living like you are now. It is also your brand new light body, taking care of it, knowing when you've torn something. Because, and I've experienced this, I've hurt my light body from the inside. I've twisted too much. I've overstretched, and you can feel a tear. It's immediate. It's sharp. And it heals pretty quickly. I mean, it'll be healed in a couple hours. But you have to understand that you have two bodies, and those bodies have multiple layers. So it is comfort. It's your health. It's also your connections to fun and entertainment. And a lot of you are not playing with your twins enough. And maybe you can't get your hands on your twin. And maybe you can't really think of any fun. And you might be like grasping at straws and saying, oh gosh, I'm out. Nothing's fun. Yeah, for a lot of you, you can't hold the fun without your beloved. But you have to do your best, because your angel body actually requires that. It needs to have fun. You know, it's the difference between forcing yourself to jog or turning on music and just bopping to the music and being silly and having fun. Feel the difference of your body. It is home, your homes, your physical structures, and your material comforts. This would be tactile sensations, materials. And when you get to the fifth dimension, you are actually the creators of this, or collaborating with others who have those gifts and talents to create what you want. And it could be things like, let's say, like a fountain. You want a water feature at your home. And, you know, doesn't matter how you live while you're here. When you get to where you really live, you do have this. Family. And pay attention here, because family of origin and your star origins, this is going to be the soul group that you rode in with. It's going to be your family of origin, which can be your biological family, or can also be people that originated with you that, like in my case, I actually had a boss who was a mother to me in other lives, but not a really good mother. You know, one of these mothers that was very controlling. Not a bad, just, you know, one of these things. And in this life, the context was boss. So, you're here to conclude these old connections and get rid of your universal karma. For a lot of you, it's coming out from the inside from some really deep levels. And I'm going to just show you here. Okay, you see this? This is a box. This box is your little human body. And inside, you've got your light body. But then, you've got all the other levels of your body. And so when you get right down to the very, very bottom level here, okay, this is how you started out. And every experience has added these layers here, and it's been covered up. And I actually, there's a coin in there. So all of these layers have been covered up, and in between, even between every layer, you got resistances, and you've got things that are impeding your progress, but it's all peeling off now, and you've stretched yourself out to the level of the universe. You've only made a connection. You have not merged yourself out to the universal level. Many of you who have experienced emerged with your twin have merged. For a lot of you, it was in 2012. That was a part of your cosmic merge. And there's more. There's more merging that's going to happen. For myself, I did a merge with my beloved in May of 2012, and I knew what it was. I absolutely knew, and our bodies fit together. This is one of the difference between twin flames. Twin flames is not a dating service. This is the person, the entity, this is your soul. This is you, how you were created and melting together. And so how could there be really differences between you? It comes from these levels of experiences. They've been here, you've been there, sometimes you guided each other, and you can't be mean to each other, you can't be against each other. You can take breaks from each other, and sometimes those breaks are planned by the universe. Now, in your universal karma, all of these old connections are being reconnected appropriately. That means that you're putting things in their appropriate place, and you're giving your union the priority. This is a big one. Your solar plexus, all the organs along your rib cage, they were connected to the old. A lot of you have had things cracking off, their gallbladder issues, liver issues, or your twin does, or maybe your twin drinks and you get liver pain or gallbladder pain, your appendix has been burst, that's Maldek. You know, all kinds of trouble along the solar plexus, diabetes, hypoglycemia. And what we've done is we have taken those connections out to the universe. We've reconnected, and we've reconnected on the inside to the heart and to the high heart. And the old earth is no longer running it. Your family's no longer running it. Your boss isn't running it. Your spouse or your ex-spouse or ex-girlfriend or anybody is not running your light body, and that's what making it so hard. Now, 2 years ago, I had those old connections cracked off through a virus, and this virus was bad. It went pretty much through my whole city, and it made me vomit. I mean, I actually felt like I detached an organ, and I was expecting blood, but I didn't. 4 days of fasting actually made everything go away, and fever shot up, burned stuff off. I mean, it was surreal. And that's what some of these horrifying things are taking. This is surreal, but it's very quick. It's short-lived. I had a context for it sort of after the fact, in the middle and after the fact. And I wanted nothing better than to get out of my body. I actually at one time refused to start on my own ascension. I told my guides, I'm going to go on a hunger strike. And they said, just try it. Just try it and see how it goes for you, because we will keep you alive, but you won't. And I was like, okay, I give, but I don't know what to do. And that's the thing here. A lot of you don't know what to do, but there's a lot of help. And this also comes out when I read for people, when I do the readings or the sessions or the consultation, you know, some of what to do, because when you do participate in whatever form that is, that you're trying to get yourself better, you're trying to help your beloved, they'll go. So the solar plexus is the new core complex. Many people will feel it this holiday season, especially in the northern hemisphere, because we've got several celebrations coming up here. The mental confusion that a lot of people have been feeling over the past 2 weeks is just the tip of the iceberg. So things like anger, frustration, irritations, annoyances, heartache, mental, emotional anguish, and sexual tension. What's sexual tension? Well, did you ever get a bill you didn't expect? And maybe that bill came, and all of a sudden you pushed down, and you felt like, oh my goodness. And, you know, what do you do with it? It's not having the reactions. And people in the fifth dimension do get angry. We have emotions. We've explored our emotions over like eons of time to the degree that it hurt. And a lot of you have tried, you know, everything. You have tried, you know, each gender in different lives. You've been each gender in different lives. And, you know, some of you are still trying that. And I will say this again. There is one exact matching vibration of your soul in the entire universe. There are not multiple twin flames. Other dimensions do not have polyamory or anything. Because think about it this way. Do you want all those energies in your union? No. Okay, so putting the love together and being thankful. Now, the initial twin flame and divine counterpart couples who will merge in this first sacred sexual merge, this is going to be the first one in approximately 8,000 years. And it will occur, and it will occur rather close together. So like in an example, think of time zones, 11-11, 11-11, 11-11, 11-11, all the way around the globe. And you go, you get this going, and what do? You're starting to accelerate things upwards, and that's part of the effect in terms of also vibing the love out to everywhere. So this will begin the healing, first and foremost, in their own union of the mental and emotional disturbances, which includes obsessive-compulsive disorder or obsessing. And how many of you had a parent who would say, who left the thing out again? And all of a sudden they turned into like some kind of petty tyrant. And you were like, hey, take it easy, mom or dad. I'm like, but as a child, you couldn't do that. You were like, they're on the rampage again. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. And, you know, this is the kind of stuff, this obsessive compulsive, the narcissism, addictions, smoking, drinking, recreational drugs, ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. This affects a lot of people as we go up through the mental miasm. It's like a slideshow passing through. ADD, bipolar, mild depression, nightmares, fears of the occult, fears that someone has cursed you or placed a curse on you or cursed your abundance, old outdated vows, curses, witches, phobias of a certain kind. Things like hearing voices and sounds, or you can look on the internet, there's all kinds of phenomena, or don't look on the internet, but things like people hearing their phone, even when the phone's been off. Just silly things like that that stay sort of connected to the mental, emotional body, and it's important to take breaks. So expect transmutation, expect adjustments in all your cycles, especially the testosterone. Males may go through a period where they are temporarily impotent while everything gets rerouted appropriately. Females may experience adjustments in their menstrual cycle, or it may cease entirely, or it may accelerate where there's not much time between it. And a lot of the pains caused by these emotional bodies, things like menstrual cramps, fibromyalgia, a lot of this stuff is going to start healing and evaporating. It's important to catch yourself with your medications and really tune in, like, do I need to take that? Because nobody's intended to be on something or be labeled as a drug addict forever here. You're expected to know that you're in your new life and you're healing this stuff. So the adjustments, and I have actually one more thing to show you, because many of these adjustments are taking place in, okay. So the old parts of you that drove you are being rerouted. So the brain, the cerebral cortex, your spinal cord, and your nervous system. Because the central nervous system of your body is connected to the central nervous system of the universe. And so your universal connections of everything. So, I mean, your body is the wireless, but you do have these connections. And it's beyond the etheric. The etheric is things like the internet, cell phones, email, text, etc., etc. You are pulling your union out of the etheric into the physical. Pay attention. Be aware of some of this stuff. If your computer breaks down, really feel that out. What does that mean? I mean, I know what it means for me. I had to detach from certain people, places, things in order to move forward, in order to jump forward. That's part of how you jump timelines here and get yourself unstuck. Enough people have been gathered. It's time to get everyone going. If you haven't done this for yourself, keep expecting. So your central nervous system, the cerebral cortex, your hands, and the sacred sexual, and the feet, particularly the toes. Now, when I read people and they want to know from me, why doesn't my twin get it? Or why do they seem stuck? Or why did they like go to religion, or they went to drinking, or they never stopped doing this? Or, you know, it's like we got together and they went back to something. And I'll tell you why. It's because it's not just a head thing. This is your heart. Your heart is driving everything. Your heart is the steering. Your soul is driving the heart. You have the high universal mind connection. So, what happens? Well, if they are still connecting with the old, if the head is saying, well, take a drink and that's going to help you cope. You know, you don't know how to let this go, and, you know, everyone in your family drinks. So, you know, we've now numbed out the sacred sexual, and we've, you know, taken the drink in our hands, and we're holding ourselves because now we're going back into old energetics. We're buying alcohol, or we're going to a bar or something like that. Or your twin is involved with someone, and what do you wind up with here? You do not have a heart connection because your heart and soul has left that marriage or relationship. You are no longer relating to it. You are in union. And you're struggling to hold this elevated state of your union, of keeping yourself up. And so what do? Well, they decide to use their mouth to kiss someone, and they decide to use their sacred sexual. And their head is telling them, oh, well, this person's nice looking and they're nice and whatever. And guess what? You have a triangulated energy here that's completely bypassing the heart. And so the person winds up really disconnecting. They're disconnected while you're trying to reconnect their heart. So, you know, it's a misuse of the sacred sexual. Now, for people that have really been holding and knowing and believing and knowing with all their heart that this person is their beloved, despite bad behavior, despite old behavior, despite whatever they're trying to grab onto that they think was a comfort. Yes, yeah, some of those things comforted in the old. Oh, I'm going to go have drinks with friends, or I'll just work. You know, work's always a faithful mistress. I'll just turn into a workaholic. That'll get me by. Then I won't have to go home to the wife and the kids because they just think I'm the person that drives the car and pays the bills anyway, and I have no fulfillment. And besides, there's that nice person that I always can flirt with and who gives me a smile. And you cannot piece together your union. You can no longer fragment yourself. And yes, you deserve 100%. You deserve 100% of the love, and it's coming to you. So what I'm going to say to you is that you have a lot of help to do this. I want to tell you, be thankful. This is a time where we especially focus on what we're grateful for, particularly in this country. I want to say this entire journey for me has been not only a series of epiphanies. I have met some fabulous people. I have traveled and met people that they know about the Ascension. They know, and maybe they don't know everything. I don't know everything. I'm not the twin flame boss. This isn't not my command center. This is my home. I'm inviting you into my home, and I'm trusting that enough of you, if even one person gets my message, because back in February when my guide said to me, after I told a friend and I said, oh, this is what's going on, and they said, you're up. Time to start making videos. And I said, I don't even know how to work the camera. Thank you very much, but I'm sorry. Look what they did to Joshua. They crucified him. I don't want to put myself out there. But, you know, I came to understand that the love of my union is protecting me. And I am loved. And I've had a lot of support to do this. I've had your support. I have had the reflection of your love. I've had your success stories. I've also had some of your bumps in the road. And believe me, I am one of those people that really, really believes in this, because all along from 8 years ago, and I will say I have been 8 years sober. I mean, I thought about making a list of all the things I've done to prepare for my union, right down, you know, getting sober to like buying new underwear. I mean, that might sound crazy. Painted the house, you know, did all kinds of stuff. And you know, you can only do what's in your means to do. If what's in your means is that you cut out pictures and you believe, or you plan, you know, where you want to go. And I don't just want to go earth places, but the gratitude to that person's parents for being the vehicle to birth them. Who cares if they came here on the freight train or something? Who cares if they came here in a crummy vehicle and had a crummy childhood? They're here. Be grateful for it. Who cares if they're kind of stuck in something that we've collectively pulled the rug out from under? They're going to keep traveling along, and yeah, they might cry and they might bemoan the fact that it's gone. And you might feel their loss and grieving that, you know, they've had to let that thing go. And you know, it's no different anytime you move forward. So the gratitude also to our brothers and sisters who've been our guides, many of whom have moved on, and some of you are intended to move into place and become the new earth guides. Not new earth guides, new earth guides. Guides of the new earth. Because a lot of you are getting ready to merge yourselves together and be able to and enabled to go there. So I'm running a little bit long here. I had a lot of things to cover. You have unseen friends who are helping you do this. You're here to be new. Know what your heart knows, because that is how you help your beloved. And I will, you know, I just want to conclude this. Thanks to the friend who gave this to me, A true friend is a gift from God. And I will say, a friend in need is a friend indeed. And whether the support for you is someone to watch your kid, or even your own kids. I actually have a message from my son. This is, I swear this is going to be the last thing that I present here. He had a message for all of you when he saw me preparing the board. Now, he's 10, so this is from a 10-year-old's perspective. Games, social networks, and the internet will mess up your mind the more time that you use them, the more time that you spend on them. And he says, by Alex Patricia's son, and he's had some lessons in this. He's had, you know, just like all of us, you spend too much time in something and it starts to mess with you. Balance your life and you'll find that things go a little smoother. Your perfection's on the inside and you're pulling it outwards. So thank you. Thank you so much for listening. I hope everyone has a very wonderful holiday, and there is more to come, and I wish you all the best. Enjoy it and don't eat too much. Bye now.